Hello, my name is Stephen Chan. I'm an assistant professor of medicine at Harvard Medical School at the Brigham and Women's Hospital in Boston, Massachusetts. Today, I'm happy to be discussing our laboratory's recent findings of microRNAs that can act as systems-level regulators in the pathogenesis of pulmonary hypertension, or PH. As many of you know, PH refers to a group of pulmonary vascular diseases that can cause increased pulmonary pressure, right heart failure, and often death. But the molecular origins of this disease remain enigmatic. Over the past decade, multitudes of newly identified molecules and pathways have been implicated in PH, but it has been challenging to understand the integrated effects of all of these factors on overall disease manifestation. MicroRNAs have been proposed as important factors in this pathogenesis. These are small, non-coding RNA molecules that negatively regulate gene expression by binding specific sequences in messenger RNA in order to cause translational repression and/or mRNA degradation. Recently, we proposed that microRNAs may serve as good candidates that exert hierarchical regulation of these complex molecular networks, given their inherent pleiotropy of repressing several messenger transcripts simultaneously. However, there are challenges of studying such complex microRNA biology using traditional scientific approaches, and so we have attempted to address these obstacles by the application of computational network theory to hone our hypotheses. However, to date, relevant high-throughput data in PH has been limited, and analysis of systems-level regulation of microRNA networks in general has consisted mostly of computational theories without experimental data. So the central objective of this study was to design a strategy combining computational analysis of PH disease gene network architecture with experimental validation that accurately identifies microRNAs exerting systems-level control of pulmonary hypertension. To do so, we leveraged a simple concept that often microRNAs tend to regulate multiple targets in the same functional pathway or network. We first wanted to determine whether such a network relevant to pulmonary hypertension could be constructed from available molecular maps. To do so, we curated 115 seed genes known to be important in PH from the scientific literature. We then mapped the functional interactions among these genes using a consolidated set of databases that represent all functional interactions among the human transcriptome and proteome. We then expanded the network to include genes that were not mentioned in the PH-relevant literature, but were known to interact closely with a number of our curated PH genes by our network analysis. The end product was a single encapsulated largest connected component carrying 249 genes and over 2,000 interconnections. We then used this PH network as a platform, coupled with a well-validated microRNA target prediction algorithm called TargetScan, in order to identify those microRNAs that have the broadest influence throughout the entire PH network. To do so, we ranked microRNAs based not only on the number of predicted targets they had within the network, but also how well distributed those targets were throughout the network itself. Based on this metric, we predicted the microRNA 130 and 301 family to be the most influential set of microRNAs in the context of PH in this regard. This is a family of four microRNAs that share the same seed sequence and thus presumably regulate the same broad cohort of PH-relevant target genes. We then performed a similar set of analyses on the targets of the miR-130 and 301 family, as well as on their closest interactors within the PH network, in order to determine which of the microRNA family targets and downstream pathways were the most influential in disease. In this way, we uncovered an intricate network of subordinate microRNA activity, spearheaded by the miR-130 target PPAR-gamma, which can regulate miR-424 and 503 in pulmonary arterial endothelial cells, as well as miR-204 in pulmonary arterial smooth muscle cells. These findings suggested to us that the miR-130-301 family serves as a regulator of both of these pathways, orchestrating a global proliferative response throughout the vasculature, ultimately culminating in pulmonary hypertension. Importantly, this process of model building was implemented entirely in silico. And while some of these individual regulatory relationships had been previously validated, the notion that they are united by a single global regulatory factor is a novel one and would have been very difficult to uncover without the aid of computational analyses such as these. We then wanted to determine and validate this model experimentally. First, in cultured pulmonary endothelial and smooth muscle cells, we used a comprehensive set of gain-of-function and loss-of-function approaches to manipulate miR-130 and 301, as well as their downstream effectors, in order to prove their pro-proliferative actions via regulation of miR-424, 503, and miR-204. Second, we examined a broad spectrum of disease models of pH, spanning 7 different models in rodents and sheep, as well as 3 different subtypes of human disease. In all cases, we found a coordinated upregulation of all miR-130, 301 family members, particularly in remodeled pulmonary vessels. Third, we identified multiple triggers of pH as key regulators of this microRNA family, including hypoxia, inflammatory cytokines, and a subset of factors known to be genetically associated with human pH. Finally, by pharmacologic manipulation of this microRNA family in the pulmonary vasculature of mice, we found miR-130 and 301 to be both necessary and sufficient for hemodynamic and histologic manifestations of pH in vivo. In conclusion, we believe that this is the first description of a single microRNA family regulating a hierarchy of subordinate microRNAs with systems-level yet cell-type-specific effects in pH. We believe that deciphering such systems-level relationships should guide the development of more effective and perhaps more potent clinical management strategies in pulmonary hypertension. Perhaps more importantly, our findings provide critical validation for the evolving application of network theory to the discovery of microRNA-based origins of pulmonary hypertension. And we hope this work can serve as a basis for the search in separate human diseases for other microRNA master regulators that are otherwise hidden in the architecture of existing network databases. Thank you very much for your interest, and on behalf of all of the authors, I hope you enjoy reading our work.